they still culling? But on this line, they're still working on something over there.
Today, we're checking oyster boats in San Antonio Bay. Weston and I, we are both from Calhoun County, and Trey is one of the inland game wardens.
Stay game warden, how are you guys? Habla ingles? Poquito?
We have 250 to 300 oyster boats, and there's only 4 game wardens in the county. Sometimes we need that extra help.
You got your licenses on board today?
What we normally look for is undersized oysters.
They have to be 3 inches.
This is a legal size oyster, but you're gonna be looking for little ones that are still stuck on that they hadn't cleaned off.
These look pretty good over here?
Yeah, they look pretty good.
Yeah, everything else is here.
All right. All right, thank you.
Gracias. On to the next one.
Which one do you want?
Oh, where's that lugger right there? That's the one. I bet that's gonna be one of those Mississippi or Louisiana boats that's over here.
Got the black hull.
All right, coming up. This year, we actually have a lot of out-of-state fishermen coming in to oyster fish. Mississippi, Louisiana have had a bad die-off of their oysters, so we've got a really high concentration of boats that are coming out here, and they've got to make sure that they're playing by the same rules as everybody else.
Can we get you on the side, or are you all right going over the back? I guess they're all right going over the back.
Stay game, Warden. How is everybody? How many we got so far? 10. We base how many sacks we count out of a cargo on how many sacks they've got on board. They can never have more than 30 sacks on board.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Is this your license?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a lot of peanuts in here. Got a handful of peanuts there on top. So we're gonna count it. We'll see. It may level itself out as we get into it. But y'all want to clean that table off for me? A peanut is a oyster between 1.5 to 3 inches.
It's 3 inches, it's gotta be. Anything that fits on, and that's like not even close, you know?
Yeah. You're not gonna be able to get an accurate measurement based off a hatchet that was probably only 2.5 to maybe 2.75 inches.
That's a lot of peanuts.
Once we count them up, folks are allowed to be in possession of 5% undersized.
I got 216 total.
92 small.
Man, you're gonna be like 50%, I think. This is all small right here.
We're up 31%. 31. Are you familiar with oyster law? Pretty flagrant. All of these were less than the 3 inches. You have your ID, sir? Okay, can I get it? They've got 10 sacks. We only, by law, have to count one. This one's been counted. The rest will have to be dumped back into the water and still be able to grow. Then they'll be legal size probably for next year. But by taking them, it's gonna deplete the population. And then, you know, eventually areas are gonna get closed. They're from Mississippi, so I just don't think he's really aware of our laws. Hopefully he'll learn something from this.
You get one citation for possession of undersized oyster cargo. How we got to that 31%, that's your total number. You had 500 exactly oysters, and you had 155 of those 500 were small. So that's how we come up with 31%. If we catch you like this again, y'all's license is gonna get suspended.
This is a big problem. If you get over 30% of undersized oysters, a second time, you're gonna get a 30-day suspension. The whole month for them not to oyster and make any money with those plates.
You can fish right here again, fish them up and clean them up better, but everything's gotta go back into the water. And be honest with you, there ain't nothing you can do to clean these up to make them better. They're just too small. Yeah.
All right, you take care.
Coming up.
Louisiana, that's where it's from.
You don't reach quite as far as I do, Chelsea.
Stay
game, Warden. How are you?
Good.
How many sacks y'all end up with?
30.
30?
Yes.
30. All right, let you have a full boat then, huh? Y'all got y'all's licenses with y'all today? 30. Are you
Good deal. You can have that back. This your first year in general, or have you been doing it in Louisiana in the past?
I've been doing this since I was 9 years old.
Yours look all right, Chelsea?
Mine did. I don't know about Weston's.
What you think, Weston?
This one's got three tiny ones on it.
Yeah.
I immediately saw a couple spats.
What spat is essentially a baby oyster. Oysters don't just randomly appear out there in the salt water. They grow on top of each other. So a spat is a small oyster that's growing on top of a larger oyster. I saw a couple in this one here, too. Will you want to count one sack? We'll see where it's at, and we can count another if we got to. You want to drop your dredge so we're not drifting?
Let's take a look at a different one.
At one point, before we became game wardens, you were allowed to keep 90 sacks of oysters. And today, it's 30 sacks. So the oyster industry is dwindling. If they want to continue with this job that they've had and passed on from generation to generation, then they need to do a better job of conserving oysters that are left in the water.
That's 62 big.
That 101 big.
Where you at?
10.2.
10.2? We took the two sacks, we added them together, we averaged it. You're at 10.2%. You're double the limit, okay?
So what happens is you and your deckhand will both get a ticket for undersized oysters.
You didn't really have a whole lot of peanuts. All your stuff is good size, but you just got a lot of spat on there that y'all got to clean off better.
Yeah. What if I go clean it off right now?
We'll let you keep the sacks that we culled because we know those are good right now. Like that, what's in that basket, we know is good. Everything else is going to have to be dumped in the water. You got to put it back in. You can pick it back out and clean it, but it's got to hit the water before you do that.
Keeping that. There ain't no problem.
Well, I'm not gonna make you keep it. If you want to throw that in too, you can. But I'm just telling you, I'll let you keep that because we cleaned it.
So I could go throw it right there where it's polluted.
No, you need to return it to the reef where they were caught.
I don't know about that.
No, I do know about it. You're gonna put them back on a reef.
They really don't make no sense. It's not about to spend 40 gallons.
If we gotta follow you out there, that's what we're gonna do.
That's what you gotta do.
So.
I don't even know where I was at.
Just listen to this. You see where those oyster boats are actually doing circles? We know there's a reef there, okay?
I was over there.
You were over here?
Yeah.
On a reef?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll come back to this reef that you were at over here and put them over there. If we just put the oysters in the middle of the bay with no other oysters around, probably just gonna sit there and die. Regardless of whether he's upset, that's what the law says. We're gonna make sure that they end up back on the reef.
One citation for possession of undersized oysters, 10.2, 30 sacks. By signing here, it's not saying you're guilty, just promising you we'll talk to a judge. Okay. Just make sure you do contact her, because if you don't, then it could turn into a warrant, all right? The legal oystering hours are from sunrise to 3:30.
You got 3.5 hours still to work. Put them in, scoop them back up, clean them up better. If he doesn't dump, he's failing to obey a lawful order of a peace officer. So if he wants to play the hardball and not dump it, well, we're gonna tack on another charge for it. You see any reefs or anything
right
on here?
Right there. Right in front of his tray.
Okay.
I don't know why he's doing it in a straight line.
There's no way he's gonna be able to pick these back up.
Uh-uh.
He's mad now.
We informed him that he'd be well within his rights to go ahead and pick them back up off the bottom and just clean them up as he went. It doesn't look like he's gonna do that today. I think he's a little upset with us. Hopefully, you know, after a little reflection, he realizes we're not doing this to pick on him. We're doing this because we're protecting the resource.